folks. Larry here from CannedHamTrailers.com, and today I've got another quick tip for you. This one involves installing the roof metal and strapping it down before you actually attach it. This is a very important step in the process, and it helps prevent buckling and keeps your metal in place while you're installing it. So let's go ahead and see how we do this. Now what you see here is 1-inch webbing. You can get this online, you can find it, just it's tubular webbing. It's normally used, the reason I have it is it's used in parachute bridles for hang gliding. But it can be used for a lot of other things. This is also used for strapping with cleats and things when you're tying down loads. But you can get this online, just look for 1-inch webbing, tubular webbing online, and you can find it. It comes in rolls, and I have a roll over there, what's left of it, that I'll show you in a little bit. And what we use this for is to strap down the metal and hold it down, get it all flat and in place while we go ahead and fold over the edges and staple it down. Now you've seen me put a roof on. If you look at the 57 Westerner series, you'll see how to put a roof on, and you'll see me doing this. But this is something I wanted to go into in a little more detail to show you how it's done. Got to show you how it's held at the bottom and held in the front, and how it's held at the bottom in the rear. And simply, it's just a 2x4 that I've placed underneath the front tongue, the metal tongue, and I've held it up with a couple of blocks, and I go ahead and I throw my straps over, keeping them flat all the way there. I throw my straps over one at a time, I tie them in front, and then I have another piece of wood in the back fastened to the trailer the same way, and almost the same way. I'll show you that in a bit. And that's the back, is where we go ahead and pull it down tight and tie them off. And like I say, this holds the metal in place and keeps it down flat, so it's already pretty much where it needs to be when you go ahead and start folding over the sides and stapling. Now let me show you something here, and you'll maybe be able to see why this helps so much. Of course, if I didn't have these straps here, the metal would be hanging way out here. Now, another safety tip that I want to give you is when the metal is out here, before you strap it down, be very careful of these corners. They're very sharp, and they'll hurt you. I ran my head into one, I forgot, and that can cut you. So be very aware of these until you get it strapped down. It's very sharp on the corners. All right, let's go ahead and walk around and look a little bit at the details. All right, it's really busy over at the airport. They've got ultralights going, they got airplanes for skydivers going, so I'm sorry about the noise. I hope you can hear me over it all. I can't wait around for it because it's gonna be 98 degrees here today and I gotta get this done. But at any rate, all I've done is place a 2x4 underneath the tongue here, as you can see, held it up with a couple of blocks like this, temporarily, and went ahead and tied my straps on in four places. And then, like I said, I swung them right over the trailer. They go all the way around, keeping it flat until they come out on this side. And by the way, you want to try and keep this one on the curbing wherever it's hitting the radius so that it's not pulling in on your vapor barrier. And I have another 2x4. This is actually a 2x3. It's a little bit smaller. And because there isn't a place out here to attach these things to, that's why you have these pieces of wood. And what I've done is, first I got it there temporarily with just a piece of wire, and then I went ahead and put zip ties around the frame that's back here. You see this frame? Okay, put zip ties here and tighten them down, all right, with a pair of pliers to hold it in place. And then I went ahead and I pulled my straps, pulled them tight as I can get them with my hands, okay, without hurting the trailer. And you don't want to pull so tight that you crease the metal up on top, and cinch them down with just a plain old square knot or half hitch, whatever kind of knot you're comfortable with. This stuff comes untied fairly easy. So done that in four places, and I start in the middle and work out. So I start with one of these, and then I do the other one in the middle, then I come to this side, and then I go to that side. And all you do, like I say, is you just pull on it like this and tighten it around here, and then cinch it down. Not much to that, really. Okay, So that's how we get it where we want it. And of course, before you do that, you're going to place your metal where you want it, both in the front and the rear. You want it level here, all right? And you want at least a half inch hanging out over. Now, you've already measured your metal when you had it made at Hemet Valley RV, when you talked to Steve, so that it was at least 2 inches wider than the trailer. Now, in the beginning, if you've never done this before, you might want to make it 4 inches wider than the trailer, just so you don't mess up. But I've done this so many times, I can get away with 1 inch on each side. And then what I do is, I get it down to around a half an inch on one side, so I only have to trim the other side. I'll have to do some trimming on this one because the trailer is not perfectly square. But as you can see, looking up here, this metal is flat down tight. It's tight against the radius all the way around. That's a good thing because it's not going to buckle. So this is being held in place by these tight straps right on, right against the curbing and right against the metal. And that's what makes this so special. That's why this is such a good trick. You can do the same thing with your rear metal and your front metal also. Now, as you can see what's going on here, you don't want to crease it. You don't want to crease your metal. So when you do the straps on the front and rear metal, you might not want to tighten them as much as you did for the roof. Just make sure you keep an eye on it when you're tightening them up and make sure you don't crease the metal. Keep this over here. Same thing on this side, as you can see. Trying not to look into the sun here. On this side, we got a little bit more overhang, so I'll be doing most of my trimming on this side because I've got to up to over an inch. Don't worry about this piece of metal. I have to slip that in before I start. So there you have it. This is a very important step. It really makes putting the metal on easier. Again, make sure that you've got your seams level with the windows. You got a front and rear window usually in the trailer. So make sure that your metal is on nice and square and level, front and rear. Make sure that you have enough overhang to be able to fold this over and get a good seal before your J-rail. You don't want to, you want to, when you cut your metal, you want to cut it down to a half an inch overhang. No more than a half an inch, because then your overhang's gonna exceed the width of the J-rail, which is only 3/4 inches. So you want to have the J-rail covering over the seam. This is the way it comes. Of course, it was a much bigger roll. It was, you know, out to here, but comes rolled up like this. And I'm not sure how many feet you get in a roll. I guess you'll see that when you go to the website. So yeah, just look this up online. Google 1-inch tubular webbing and you'll see all kinds of results there. So just to show you how I tighten this up, as you can see, I've got a block over here and I'm using my router box because it's about the right size, with some blocks over here, and I've thrown the straps over the trailer and made sure they're flat all the way around. You might want to get some help on this. One thing I also do is on the ends, I pull up further than just tight with this, with the frame. I pull it up a little further. That way when I pull the box out, it's going to pull down and give even more tension on the edges. And the edges is where it's most important, because that's where we're doing our fold over and that's where we get our buckling. Remember to go to the 57 Westerner series, watch that series, and you'll see how to put a roof on. It's on my website. Everything is indexed. All the videos I've made for trailer restoral is on there, indexed, easy to find. And if you can't find something, just send me an email. All right, let's go to the rear and we'll see how we tie this up. Okay, as I said, start in the middle and work out. So I'm gonna go ahead and pull this guy tight. And I start by pulling down, not too much. You don't want to crease the metal, but you can tell when it's tight.
Okay. I'm going to keep it somewhat straight. Pull a little more. You just pull out on the strap to get it tight and then pull up from the bottom, see? And that cinches it down. Kind of like cinching up a saddle if you've ever done that. I haven't done that in a lot of years. All right, so if we go over it twice like this, it won't slip on you. And then it's just a simple half hitch knot. I think that's what it's called. It's been a long time since I was a Boy Scout. That's all we do right there. And we go to the outside and do the same thing and try and keep it on. You want to keep it on the curbing. Remember the curbing? Keep it on there. All right, so we get it snugged up. And then we pull out on it. I'll do it down here where you can see. Pull out on it while holding it. Cinch it up. I want to get it over here where it's on the curbing. There. Cinch it up. Pull out on it. Cinch it up. Now we wrap it twice. Give it a half hitch. And then when we pull those blocks out, the block on one side and the box on the other, from the front, this will tighten up even more. And like I say, the curbing, the edges, that's where it's most important. Keep this on the curbing. There. So it doesn't mess up your vapor barrier. All right, let's go to the front. Okay, again, make sure that your strap is on the curbing, and then just go ahead and slip these blocks out. This 2x4 will pull down even more, making it even tighter. So there you go. That's how we strap down the metal for the roof. You can do the same thing for the front and the rear. It helps. You don't have to for the front and rear. You've seen me do it without the strapping before, but I've done this a lot. So for you doing it your first time, you might want to do it, because that makes sure the metal is flat and where it's supposed to be before you start folding over the metal. And that's very important to keep the buckling from happening.
All right, I hope this tip helps you with the building of your trailer. Don't forget to go to my website, cannedhamtrailers.com, for more tips and tricks on how to do all this stuff. I'm here to help. This is Larry from cannedhamtrailers.com, signing off till next time. Happy trailering. All right, I hope that quick tip helps. Blah, blah, blah. All right, I hope this quick tip helps you with your roof. Blah, blah, blah.